स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. वि लुकिङ्ग् एट् अलङ्कारेषु ध्वनेः अन्तर्भावस्य निरासः. वै ध्वनि केनाट् बि इन्क्लूडेड् अण्डर् अलङ्कारस् एण्ड् वेर् एस् सो हि टुक् अप् एक्साम्पल्स् आफ़् ईच् एण्ड् एव्रि अलङ्कार एण्ड् गिव् अस् इन् शङ्कर यस्टर्डे यु हेड् अ डौट् सो I just wanted to point out it's actually present in Lochana. That example is given in Lochanam, which I couldn't find it yesterday. So it is given as an example of anugrahya anugrahaka bhava sankaraha, and the reason he gives for that is paraspara upakarena yatra alankratayah astitah swatantrena atmalabham no labhante so api sankaraha. So Abhinavagupta takes another definition for sankara, where he says when one alankara cannot exist without the other alankara, so that is also an example of sankara, where it is very clear that certain alankara, see, sandeha alankaram need not always have upama as its base. It could be anything also, just utpreksha can also be there, but upama is there, I understand. But here he wants to specifically say sandeha and upama cannot be without each other, and just taking that point, he explains that sankara. So I just wanted to touch on that. If you have further doubt, we will deal with that later. Now we'll move on to aprastuta prashamsa. Anandavardhana does not give any examples. We have to go to Abhinavagupta for these, or Didhiti. Some of the examples I've taken from there also. Aprastuta prashamsayam yada samanya vishesha bhavat nimitta nimitti bhavat va abhidiyamanasya aprastutasya pratiyamanena prastutena अभिसम्बन्धः तदा अभिधीयमानप्रतीयमानयोः सममेव प्राधान्यम्. इवन् इन् अप्रस्तुतप्रशंसा अभिधीयमानप्रतीयमानयोः समम् एव प्राधान्यम्. देर् द इम्पार्टेन्स् फार् बोत् द प्रैमरि मीनिङ्ग् एण्ड् द प्रतीयमानं सजेस्टेड् मीनिङ्ग् आर् सेम् इन् अप्रस्तुतप्रशंसा. सो दि एक्साम्पल्स् हि हेस् टेकन् आफ् The alankaras that he has taken for example are all very carefully chosen. Actually, they are not random selections, because later you will see in the sankshepa he is going to say why each and every of those have been taken to satisfy four different conditions under which dhvani could be included. So because of these four things we don't include dhvani. He is going to tell that later. So let's look at this here. That samameva pradhanyam is very important. What is the lakshanam for aprastuta prashamsa? Adhikarat apetasya vastuno anyasya yastutihi aprastuta prashamsa sa trividha parikirtita. Adhikarat apetasya. Adhikaram means prastutam, that which is the contextual. प्रस्तुत विषयात् अपेतस्य वस्तुनः. सो यु हेव् अ काण्टेक्स्चुअल् हेपनिङ्ग्, यु हेव् अ काण्टेक्स्ट् एण्ड् अ नान् काण्टेक्स्ट्. सो हौ आर् दे टु कनेक्टेड्? बै प्रेसिङ्ग् आर् बै डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् दि अप्रस्तुतं. यत्र वाच्ये अप्रस्तुतं वर्णितम् अस्ति व्यङ्ग्यत्वेन प्रस्तुतं च प्रतीयते तत्र अप्रस्तुत प्रशंसा. सो अप्रस्तुतस्य प्रशंसा यत्र क्रियते. अधिकारात् अपेतस्य वस्तुनः अन्यस्य वस्तुनः या स्तुतिः. सो प्रस्तुतात् अपेतस्य रहितस्य वस्तुनः, विच् इस् अप्रस्तुतस्य, अ नान् काण्टेक्स्चुअल् इश्यू इस् बीङ्ग् पोर्ट्रेड् इन् द श्लोक, एण्ड् वि अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् द काण्टेक्स्ट् फ्रम् द गिवन् श्लोक. Most of these proverbs go by that, or not general proverbs like you know, honesty is the best policy and all that, but in the Tamil we have a lot of these. The oyera oyera parandalu oor oor pura parundu ena oor pura parundagadu abrimba. How much ever a sparrow tries to fly high, it is not going to become an eagle. That's the literal translation of that. So these are all things where whatever a person tries, if it is beyond his capability, he cannot attain a position that is completely beyond his capabilities. That is the context here that someone wishes to convey, but he uses a non-contextual description of a story. All these morals, Aesop's fables and all come under that for you. So aprastuta prashamsa sa trividha mata. So what are the three ways in which aprastutam can be used here? Samanya vishesha bhavat, nimitta nimitti bhavat. These are actually two, but that samanya vishesham also, samanyat vishesha pratitihi, visheshat samanya pratitihi, and nimitta nimitti bhavam is karyakarana bhavam. These are the three ways in which aprastuta, from the aprastuta vachyam, we get vyangyam as prastutam. The first example is, so aprastuta prashamsayam yada samanya vishesha bhavat nimitti nimitta bhavat va abhidiyamanasya vachyasya vachyarthasya aprastutasya, the non-contextual, pratiyamanena prastutena abhisambandhaha. There is a connection between the context which is suggested and the non-context which is being described. That abhisambandha yada bhavati tada abhidiyamana pratiyamana yoho samameva pradhanyam. Then there is equal importance given to both the vachyartha and the pratiyamanartha. It's still, this is not dhvani. This can be a pravedam of dhvani, maybe. If the vyangyartha is so much more beautiful than this. So yada tavat samanyasya aprastutasya abhidiyamanasya, this is the first variety. Yada tavat samanyasya aprastutasya is equal to abhidiyamanasya. Both of all these are as an adjective, or when samanyam means a general thing, like great people. Vishesham is Hanuman. If I say, so Hanuman abdim atarat, if I say, Hanuman abdim atarat, that's all I'm saying. I'm not using the second word, otherwise it will get confusing with another alankara. So let's just take, if there is a general class of things where I say great people, and one particular person in that is Hanuman. So samanyam and vishesham are those two. So samanyasya, general category of things, aprastutam, that is the non-context, and that is being described. Prakaranikena visheshena pratiyamanena. Prakaranikam, prakaranikam is also prastutam, which is the context. Prakaranikena pratiyamanena sambandha, visheshena sambandha. Vishesha is the particular object or particular person. Sambandha tada vishesha pratitau satyamapi. Even though we have the suggestion of a vishesha, pradhanyena tat samanyena avinabhavat samanyasyapi pradhanyam. It cannot exist without the samanya which is being expressed in the vachya. Pradhanyena tat samanyena. So pradhanyam is what? Importance is given to the samanyam. And that samanya, samanyena, avinabhavat, it cannot exist without it. Ityukte samanyasyapi pradhanyam tatra bhavati. So pratiyamanasyapi, pratiyamanasya visheshasyapi pradhanyam vartate, abhideyamanasya samanyasyapi pradhanyam vartate. When we see the example, it will be very clear. Aho samsara nairghrinyam, aho dauratmyam apadam, aho nisarga jikmasya duranta gatayo vidhehe. A very simple shloka where he just laments about the vidhi, samsara nairghrinyam, the cruelty of samsara, this world, the worldly life. Samsara is the life that you lead in this world because of the attachments that you have. Samsara nairghrinyam, the cruelty of, look at the cruelty of the worldly life. Apadam dauratnyam, apat, misfortune or disasters. Dauratnyam, duratmaha bhavaha dauratnyam. So bad nature, look at the bad nature of misfortune or bad nature of disasters, the bad results that we get out of disasters. Nisarga jikmasya videhe gatayaha aho duranta. Videhe gatayaha. Vidhi, the fate, the ways of fate are in fact so, vidhi itself, the adjective he gives for vidhi is nisarga jikmasya. By nature, it is very twisted. It's very kutilam. So, nisarga kutilasya videhe daivasya gatayaha margaha. The ways of vidhi are duranta. Dukkha antayukta. It has a very bad end to it. So, the tragic ends the tragic end of fate's ways. Huh? So, aho nisarga jimmasya duranta gatayaha videya. Now, what is he trying to say with this? This is a samanya. This is a general description of how cruel the worldly life is, how bad the disasters can be in this life, and how the ways of fate always have a very tragic end. So, it is actually someone who has experienced or who is experiencing a misfortune in his life, or he has lost something very dear to him. He is saying this shloka. He is not, so the prastutam is, we understand someone who has lost something very dear to him, is saying this, conveying his personal grief through this samanyam, which is a generalized statement of how tragic or cruel this world is. Right? So, aprastutam samanya rupam daivam atra varnitam. Daivasya gatayaha varnitaha. Prastute vastuni kvapi vinashte vishesha rupe paryavasyati. So it ultimately ends in the vishesha rupa or a particular person who has lost something which is dear to him. Either a person or he has lost his wealth, his children, whatever. Any disaster that personally happens to a person, that instead of saying it, I have lost my son or I have lost my wife, instead of portraying his own grief, he generalizes it by saying the world. We always say the world is very bad, I have bad luck. You never say I have experienced this. So samanya vishesha bhava is something very naturally we use in our language every day. So aho samsara nairghrinyam aho dhauratnyam apadam aho nisarga jimmasya duranta gatayaha videhe. Now here vidhi is not the context. A person's specific grief is the context. And that specific grief is not mentioned in the shloka. It is only pratiyamanam. It is suggested. So the suggestion is also important. What he says about the tragic ways of vidhi is also important. So samapradhanyam aprastuta prashamsayam. This is one variety of aprastuta prashamsa where samanya aprastutat vishesha prastutasya gamyatvam. Next is yadapi, the text says yadapi visheshasya samanya nishtatvam tadapi samanyasya pradhanye samanye sarva visheshanam antarbhavat visheshasya api pradhanyam. The clue he gives here is you're saying a vishesha aprastutam, which is aprastutam. So the non-context particular object you're describing, and you are getting the idea of a general person. So the it will become very clear from the shlokam, and then I'll go back to the line. So the line here is the shloka he gives is in Diditi Ankadhiropita Mrigas Chandrama Mrigalanchanaha. Kesari Nishturakshita Mrigayutho Mrigadipaha. This is from Shishvalodam, second sarga, where Balrama advises Krishna. So he says, you cannot always, keep on accepting whatever Shishupala does to you. You don't pamper him too much. If you pamper, it is only going to be a bad name for you. You have to behave in such a manner only when you attack him can you show your supremacy? Only when you show your power, you can show your supremacy over him. You can rule over him. So that is the idea here. Only a Krur Prabhu will have more power to rule. So the example he gives is a Vishesha example. Ankadhiropita Mrigaha. Chandrama Mriga Lanchanaha. Lanchana means he has the chinnam or kalankam. We say that Chandra has a kalanka of Mriga, deer. He is marked by the deer. It is not a good mark. Huh? Lanchana is also known as kalankam. Even though he takes the deer and puts it on his lap. So imagine, like, the Chandra has the Mriga in his lap there. So Anka Adhiropita Mrigaha Chandramaha. The moon took the deer in its lap and he is called Mriga Lanchanaha. Kesari Simhaha. What is happening? But when the Simha, he fell on the entire herd of deer. He falls, right? Nishturakshipta. In a very cruel manner, he attacks the entire deer herd. So, Nishturakshipta Mriga Yuthaha Kesari Simhaha Tasya Konama Kimnama Mrigadhipaha. So, he is called as the king of jungle, king of all the animals. So, the idea is don't behave very softly towards people who have to be dealt with an iron hand. So it's like a Krura Prabhu is the Samanya Rupam here. Vishesham is actually the Simhaha and the Mrigaha. If a king, or generally a king is very soft, kings, the soft kings are very, those who don't know how to attack, who don't go to war, are won over easily. And if you go and show your power, then you can rule over them. Then you can claim sovereignty over other people. That's the idea. So that is the Samanya Rupam here. Samanya Rupe Krura Prabhutve Paryavasyati Yatra. Paryavasyati means it goes and ends there. So you understand that as the Gamyam. The Aprastutam is non-context. Vishesha, you are particularly mentioning Chandramaha and Kesari. From there, you understand Samanya Mridu Prabhutvam and Krura Prabhutva Samanyam Jnayate. Now, Yadapi Visheshasya Samanya Nishthatvam. It is based on this Vishesha has been used in the particular shloka as a Vachyartha to Samanya Nishthatvam, to highlight the Samanyam. Tadapi, even there, even in those places, Samanyasya Pradhanye, the Samanyam gains Pradhanyam. It is important because Samanye Sarva Visheshanam Antarbhavaha. When I say Krura Prabhuhu, we include every dictator that has been there in the world, along with the Simha also. Right? Everybody is included, including the Vishesha that has been mentioned in the shloka. So, Samanyetu Sarva Visheshanam Antarbhavat Visheshasyapi Pradhanyam. Even that Vishesha is important. So, Samapradhanyam. Okay. Next is Nimitta Nimitti Bhave Cha Ayameva Nyayaha. This Nimitta Nimitti Bhavam is Karyakarana Bhavam. Nimittam is Karanam. Nimitti nimittam asya asti iti nimitti or karyam. You can also call it as naimittikam. Aprastutat nimittat vachyat prastutasya naimittikasya gamyatve udaharanam. When the prastutam, when the karanam is given in the vachyartha, which is also an aprastutam, the karyam is prastutam. Which is gamyam. So ye yanti abhyudaye pritim no ujjanti vyasaneshu cha te bandhavaha te suhrudaha lokaha swarthaparaha aparaha. This is given in lochanam. So ye abhyudaye pritim yanti vyasaneshu cha na ujjanti. those who do not forsake, those who abhyudaye during prosperity, those people who rejoice during prosperity, pritim nyanti, those, see, he's talking about friends and relatives. Who are friends and relatives in this world? And who are all selfish people? So you can call only those people as friends and relatives. Te eva bandhavaha, te eva suhrudaha loke, ke ye abhyudaye pritim nyanti. So when we are feeling very happy, or in during our times of prosperity, when another person also feels happy, then that means he is your friend. If another person, oh, you have got such a great mark, you have got gold medal, wow, I didn't get it. So when, that means it's a jealousy that is being shown there. So the moment someone shows, oh, I'm so happy for you, that means that person is a bandhava or a suhrit. So ye abhyudaye. अस्मदभ्युदये अथवा युष्मदभ्युदये प्रीतिं यान्ति तथापि व्यसनेषु न उज्झन्ति. When we are facing a dire, when we are in a need of people, or when we are in facing adversities, व्यसनेषु, during dangers, न उज्झन्ति, those who do not forsake you, ते एव बान्धवाः, ते एव सुहृदः. अपरः लोकः स्वार्थपरः, लोकः इत्युक्ते लोके विद्यमानाः जनाः. सो द रेस्ट् आफ् दि अदर् पीपल् आर् आल् स्वार्थपराः, देर् इस् मियर् सेल्फिश् पीपल्. नौ अप्रस्तुतं, द काण्टेक्स्ट् नान् काण्टेक्स्चुवल् हियर् इस् कारणं सुहृत् बान्धवरूपत्वम्. सो इमेजिन् द सीन् हियर् एस् समन् हू इस् ट्रैङ्ग् टु अड्वैस् यू. And maybe you are in a difficult situation and he is coming and advising you. At the same time, before starting, he says, Ye yanti abhyudaye pritim no janti vesaneshu cha te bandhavaha te sukhridaha lokaha swarthaparaha aparaha. And he starts advising. So which means, you can believe in whatever I am saying. So that he wants to convey that meaning to the person who is standing in front of him. So only those people who are with you and do not forsake you during adversities are the people you have to believe in. Why? Because they are the people who do not forsake you, and they are your sukhrit. And sukhrit karanat tesham vachaneshu vishwasaha kartavyaha iti karyarupam naimittikam vyangyam gamyate tadeva prastutamatra. So it is like a purva pitika for an advice, maybe. This is something that every mother starts off with for her child. She say, you know, all I'm saying is only for your own good. And then we will start. The moment that line comes off, all children, I think, will just shut off their indriyams. They will switch it off. But yes, that's the idea here. So, aprastutam suhrit bandhava rupatvam nimittam karanam tat vachyamatra. तस्मात् स्ववचनं विश्वसनीयम् इति कार्यरूपं नैमित्तिकम् अत्र प्रस्तुतं तथैव गम्यते. हियर् सो द नेक्स्ट् लैन् हि सेस् इस् यदा तु सारूप्यमात्रवशेन, दट् वि विल् मूव् टु द नेक्स्ट्. सारूप्यमात्रम् इस् अनदर् वेरैटि वेर् जस्ट् मियर्लि बेस्ड् आन् सारूप्यम् और् सिमिलारिटि अप्रस्तुत प्रशंसा केन् अकर्. सो वि सा त्री टैप्स्, from samanyat visheshah, visheshat samanyam, and then karanat karyam. There are other varieties also, karyat karanam. I am not going too much into all the details. So what the idea is, vachyat gamyam, and both are relevant in aprastuta prashamsa, which means there is samapradhanyam in aprastuta prashamsa. Now yadatu सारूप्यमात्रवशेन अप्रस्तुतप्रशंसायाम् अप्रकृतप्रकृतयोः सम्बन्धः, तदापि अप्रस्तुतस्य स्वरूपस्य अभिधीयमानस्य प्राधान्येन अविवक्षायां ध्वनौ एव अन्तःपातः इतरथा तु अलङ्कारान्तरम् एव. नहि कन्क्लूड्स् वित् वन् मोर् variety where there is just a similarity of action, there is no general to saman, there is no samanya to vishesha or vishesha to samanya, there is just an aprastuta to prastuta, because based on the similarity between two things. So it could be vishesha to vishesha. You don't know, right? So then it is only sarupya vashena. So yadatu, when sarupya matra vashena, just out of similarity, aprastuta prashamsayam aprakrita prakritayoho sambandha kriyate. When there is a connection between the aprakrita and the prakrita, context and non-context and context, tadapi, even in that cases, aprastutasya sarupasya, the non-context which is equal to the which is being described, and it is of the same form of the gamyam sarupam, gamyena saha sarupasya pradhanyena avivakshayam. If that prastutam is not pradhanyam, sorry, if the aprastutam which is expressed, which is the vachya, vachya rupena uktam aprastutam vishayam pradhanyena na uktam chete, then your vengyartha becomes pradhana, and there you can say it is a prabheda of dhvani. Itharatatu, when the vengya is apradhana, alankarantarameva, it only serves as an alankara prabheda and not a dhvani prabheda. Now, what is this sarupya matra visesham? You don't need this shlokam, but this is a very interesting shloka, so I just took it up from Losanam. Pranayena samarpita tava samarpitas tava balad yena tvam utthapitaha skandhe yasya chiram sthitosi vidadhe yaste saparyamapi tasya asya smitamatrakena janayan pranapahara kriyam bhrataha pratyupakarinam dhuri param vetala leelayase. Is addressing a some person who has the another Shainandri Kondravan, Kritagnaha, a person who does not have gratitude. Ingrata, I think you can say that. So Kritagnaha is a person who doesn't have any gratitude, who is not grateful to another person, or he doesn't. He Kritam Yaha Hanti Iti Kritagnaha. Tadrisha Purusham Atra Varnayati. So Prana, he is comparing him to a Vetala. You know, the Vetala is a corpse which has been brought back to life. So the moment it is brought back to life, you remember Vikram or Vetal stories. So Vikrama takes that Vetalam on his shoulders and goes. But the plan of that Vetalam is to kill Vikrama. So Kritam Yaha Hanti. Pranaha Yena Samarpitaha Tava Balad Yena Tvam Utthapitaha. Tava yena balat tava pranaha yena samarpitaha yena cha balat tvam uttapitaha. So he is addressing that Vetala and saying, hey bhrataha Vetala, brother. So just as an address, yena, by whom you were given life, pranaha samarpitaha tava, he brought you back to life, sva balat yena tvam uttapitaha, you were risen from the dead. So you were made to rise from the dead because of his strength. He gave you life, and because of his strength, you could get up. Skandhe yasya chiram sthitaha asi, by on whose shoulder you stood for a long time. Yaha te saparyamapi vidade, one who also served you a lot. Saparya pujamapi vidade, pujamapi akarot. Tasya tasya asya, tasya asya purasthitasya manushyasya smitamatrakena, by just a smile prana avaharakriyam janayan, you remove his life, or you kill him, you remove that breath of life from him by just smiling. Pratyupakarinam dhuri param leelayase, you enjoy the foremost position. Leelayase, you are sporting or playing in the dhuri, in the foremost position of pratyupakari, one who performs upakaram for others. It is a like a vyajastuti. So you are the greatest among people who are actually grateful, because what do? You kill the person who has done so much of puja for you, who has given you, brought you to life, who has kept you on his shoulders for a long time, tasya smitamatrakena, just by merely smiling, you take away his life. The Tamil, kuda irundhu kuli varikirudhu. You stay with someone and you destroy him. That's this partnership, and you get betrayed by your partner. That is what this is. So yadyapi sarupya vashena kritagnaha kaschit anyaha prastutaha akshipyate. See, here you're talking of a person who is not grateful, and you're saying you do exactly what should not be done. You make the other person trust you so much, and then at the last moment you kill him or betray him. In fact, when you have to pratyupakaraha yatra kartavyaha tat na kritam. So that is your idea here he's trying to convey. So sarupya vashena, by similarity, kritagnaha kaschit anyaha prastutaha. So the contextual person is an ingrate, or a person who doesn't have gratitude. Saha akshipyate hi gamyate. Tathapi aprastutasyaiva, the non-contextual Vedala story is more beautiful. Chamatkaritvam. This is your sarupya matra vashena. Aprakrita prakritrasa. There is no samanya visheshaṁ here. Or there is only vishesha and vishesha. So which means when you are comparing two objects like Mukhachandra. So you are comparing a Vedala and the Kritagna. Just one person he is addressing and he is talking to him. So tada api aprastutasya sarupasya abhidiyamanasya pradhanyena avivakshayam dvanau eva antapataha. If the kritagnaha is the pradhanyam, if it had been the pradhanyam, then it is dvanau eva antapataha, it is vastudvani or something like that. Whereas since in this shlokam, actually Lochana, he gives another shloka where the pratiyamanam is more beautiful. I like this shloka more than that, so I took this as an example. So here the pratiyamanam, sorry.
Adhu solvela.
Adhu va. Romba onnu iduva illa. Chamatkarama illa. Adhu vandhu yatha mamaivan vera Abhinavaguptharoda shloka madhu. Bhava vrata hatat janasya hridayani akramya yen nartayanna भंगीभिः विविधाभिः आत्महृदयं प्रच्छाद्य संक्रीडसे सत्वाम् आह जडं ततः सुहृदयं मन्यतु अदुशिक्षितः वा मन्यत्व दुशिक्षितः अन्यत्व दुशिक्षितः पाकल मन्ये अमुष्य जडात्मता स्तुतिपदं त्वत्साम्य संभावनात् इट्स नॉट सो attractive to me, adnala na apdi utten adu. He is talking of a jada vastu anga. In fact, in one discussion, they take this shloka and say the pratiyamanartham is so difficult to understand, and we understand it only because of Abhinavagupta's commentary below that. Adnala da na adu edukala.
Oh.
Ama, so utru adu. This is very nice. Avivakshayam dvanau eva antapataha. So if there is no pradhanyam for the vengyartha, if the vengyartham has pradhanyam, then it is a dvani visesham. Or if like in this Vetala shloka, itarathatu. In other cases, that is where the vengyartha is not pradhanam, it is not important. Tatutu tatra alankarantarameva. It is a category of aprastuta prashamsa. That's all. Alankara prabedaha. Okay. Now, tadayam sankshepaha. Now, the conclusion for this section of how dvani cannot be included under alankaras. He gives a set of three shlokas. Vyangyasya yatra apradhanyam vachyamatra anuyayinaha. समासोक्त्यादयः तत्र वाच्यालङ्कृतयः स्फुटाः व्यङ्ग्यस्य प्रतिभामात्रे वाच्यार्थ अनुगमे अपि वा न ध्वनिः यत्र वा तस्य प्राधान्यं न प्रतीयते तत्परावेव शब्दार्थौ यत्र व्यङ्ग्यं प्रतिस्थितौ ध्वनेः स एव विषयः मन्तव्यः संकरोज्झितः तस्मात् न ध्वनेः अन्यत्र अन्तर्भावः हितश्च न अन्तर्भावः यतः काव्यविशेषः अङ्गी ध्वनिः इति कथितः सो व्यङ्ग्यस्य यत्र अप्राधान्यम् इट् टेक्स् अप् फोर् प्लेसेस् इन् कन्क्लूशन् इफ् यु लुक् एट् आल् द डिफरेण्ट् अलङ्कारास् दट् ही हस् टेकन् यु केन् स्प्लिट् इट् इन् टु फोर् टैप्स् वेर् चतुर्षु प्रकारेषु धनव्यवहारः न दृश्यते Even if it is there, even if the vyangyartham is there, yatra yasmin kavye vyangyasya apradhanyam. Why? When the pratimanartha suggested meaning is not important, vachyamatra anuyayinaha, vachyartha upaskarakatvat, samasoktyadayaha, that is your example for that. Samasokti, akshepa and anukta nimitta visheshvakti. These will come under this. Yes. These three alankaras should come under the first variety where it helps the vachyartha. Vachyartha upaskarakam. It only helps the vachyartha and the vyangyartham is not as important. So vyangyarthasya apradhanye kimartham? The answer is vachyamatra anuyayinaha vyangyasya. That suggested meaning which only helps or follows the vachyartha and that vyangya is apradhanam. Tatra, in those cases, tasmin kavye, samasoktyadayaha, samasokti etc., vachyalankritayaha, sputaha, arthalankaraha, sputaha eva. It is very clear that those are all arthalankarasthalas, example, samasokti etc. The next category is Pratibha matre. Pratibha is not your creativity. Here, pratibha is abhasa matra, where there is just a vyangya abhasa or there is a shade, a vyangya chaya vartate. Yatra, tatra. Next one is vachyartha anugame api. Anugamam, vachyartha anugama is samapradhanyam of aprastha prashamsa, where it follows the vachyartham. Whether the vachya, either it follows the vachyartha or the vachyartha follows the vyangyartha. In either ways, it is samapradhanyam. Pratibha matram means there is an abhasa matram where you have apannuti and deepakalankara. The pratyamanam is upama. In apannuti, deepakam, etc., you have the upama alankara which is pratyamanam. But that is just there is just a shadow of that upama that is there. That's all. So vyangyasya upama alankarasya upama mishrite mishrita sthale pratibha matre. So he says mlishta is a word which he uses for aspashtam. So it's not very clearly, you can't say that upama is there. So pratibha matre sati, that is your second. Vachyartha anugame piva, or in places where it closely follows the vachyartha. So the vachya and the vyangya are going so parallelly and interconnected at the same time. So which means there is a samar pradhanyam. That's why it closely follows the vachyartha. Na dvanihi yatra va tasya pradhanyam na pratiyate. So tasya yatra tasya pradhanyam na pratiyate tatra api na dvanihi vidyate. Na dvanihi yatra va tasya pradhanyam na pratiyate. So when we don't even understand the pradhanatvam of the vyangyam, if we cannot grasp that dvani is more important, we only see the beauty of the shlokam that we see in front of us, where the asputa pradhanyam, that is also where you cannot include dvani. Now do not confuse, if you have already studied Kavya Prakasham, fifth Ullasa, you will know that there is a section called Guni Bhuta Vyangyam, and half of these descriptions will seem as if it is an explanation of Guni Bhuta Vyangyam. Yes, some of these can fall under Guni Bhuta Vyangyam, where there is an Asputa Pradhanyam, Samapradhanyam, it can come there also. But in this context, Prakrita Vishayam, that is the context here is why certain things cannot be, why in certain places, in certain kavyams, it is not considered as dhvani. So the four types from these two shlokas are, one is vachyamatra anuyayi, where the vyangyasya pradhanyatvam nasti vachyasya upaskarakatvat, because it is vachya, it becomes gunibhutam, it becomes tirobhutam as far when we look at the vyangyartham. So the vachyartham is more chamatkari than the vyangyartham. That is your first example, first prakaram. The second one is mlishta pratito or aspashta pratiti, which is pratibha matre, where there is just a chaya of the vyangyartha. The third one is samapradhanam, like in aprastuta prashamsa, vachyartha anugame api. The last is asputa pradhanyam, where there is no clear importance given to the vyangyartha. Yatra na pratiyate, pradhanyam na pratiyate. Tatparau yeva shabdarthau, yatra vyangyam pratisthidau. Yatra yasmin kavye vyang, or yasmin alankarasthale. So, tatparau yeva shabdarthau, dhvani parau yeva shabdarthau, yatra vyangyam pratisthidau, they are... One minute. Sankara ujjitaha. Dvanehe saeva vishayaha mantavyaha. So that is, it is considered as dvani vishaya only when the shabda and the artha are placed in such a manner that it is giving importance to vyangyam. Vyangyam prati eva sthitau shabdartho. Sayeva dvanehe vishayaha mantavyaha sankara ujjitaha, because sankara ujjitaha means in sankara alankara it is a very tough thing where you know you cannot decide. There are two alankaras, the chandeha sankara especially, there are three four alankaras that are there and you cannot decide which alankara is better. So Sankara is a discussion by itself. It's a separate discussion. So let's not go there, he says. And the rest all should be in such a manner that it is dvani param eva. Tasmat na dvanehe anyatra antarbhavaha. So dvani cannot be included in alankara. Anyatra alankareshu dvanehe antarbhavaha na bhavati. Itascha na antarbhavaha. The reason for not including it is yataha, the reason being kavya visheshaha angi dvanihi iti kathitaha. Dvani is spoken of as the angi pradhanam, and that is the kavya element which is spoken of as angi, and hence it cannot be included under the anga, which is alankara. So tasya punaha angani alankaraha gunaha vrittayaha cha pratipadayishyante. I'm reading from the text. So the tasya angani, dhvanehe angani, alankaraha, alankara, guna, vritti, all of these will be said later. Nacha avayavaha eva pritakbhutaha avayavi iti prasiddhaha. We'll look at this next class. And then we can start on that bhakti, why lakshana and dhvani cannot be the same, why dhvani cannot be included under lakshana. Any doubts? Ini perissa edho amichirkeni ire
illa eedi vachunta marandra poi poradha.
Okay But will this stay? I don't know if you write in this chat, it will be there.
இது கிளிப்போர்ட்ல காப்பி பண்ணி வச்சிருக்கேன் எதுக்கும்.
சரி.
Just in the, நான் சொல்லிடுறேன் பட் லைக் சமத்காரித்வம் வர்சஸ் விவக்ஷா இதுதான் எனக்கு வந்து டவுட்டா இருக்கு. சில சமயம் அவர் வந்து இப்ப இந்த சமாசோக்தி அண்ட் தீபக அலங்காரம் எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ் கொடுக்காச்சு. ஹி யூஸ் தி ஆர்குமெண்ட், ஓ எந்த அர்த்தத்துக்கு விவக்ஷா இருக்கோ அதுக்குதான் பிராதான்யம் இருக்கு. இந்த இடத்துல வியங்கியத்துக்கு வியங்கியம் வந்து விவக்ஷா கிடையாது அதுக்கு, அதனால அது வந்து அப்பிரதானமா இருக்கு, துவனி ஸ்லோகம்னு சொல்ல முடியாது அப்படின்னு. சில இடத்துல வந்து வாச்சியார்த்தம் ஒன்றும் சமத்காரமா இருக்கு, அவர் வியங்கியார்த்தம் லெஸ் சமத்காரம் யுக்தமா இருக்கு, அதனால அது துவனியில வராதுன்னு சொல்றாரு. இப்ப இந்த வேதாள ஸ்லோகத்துல வந்து எனக்கு வந்து ஐ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் எது வந்து சமத்காரமா இருக்கிறது, அந்த வேதாள அர்த்தம் தான் புரியறது வாச்சியார்த்தம். பட் ஆனா விவக்ஷா வந்து அந்த சொல்றவனுக்கு வந்து அந்த கிருதஜ்ஞான பார்த்து இருக்கிற மாதிரி, அந்த வெங்கியார்த்தம் தான் விவக்ஷா, வெங்கியார்த்தத்துக்கு தான் விவக்ஷா இருக்குன்ற மாதிரி தோன்றது. சோ எந்த ஆர்குமெண்ட்டை எப்ப யூஸ் பண்ணணும், இல்ல இந்த மாதிரி நான் புரிஞ்சுட்டு இருக்கிறதே தப்பா, இந்த மாதிரி டூ ஆர்குமெண்ட்ஸ் இருக்குன்றது
அப்படி இல்ல, புரிஞ்சுட்டு இருக்கிறது புரிஞ்சுக்கலாங்கிறது இல்ல. See, it's a point of what, okay. சமத்காரித்வம் வெர்சஸ் விவக்ஷாங்கிறது இஸ் நாட் அட் ஆல் சம்திங் தட் ஹாஸ் டு பி அ டாபிக் ஹியர். ஓகே, சோ ரெண்டுமே கேன் கோ எக்ஸிஸ்ட் ஆஸ் ஃபார் அஸ் துவனி கோஸ், இட் ஹாஸ் டு கோ எக்ஸிஸ்ட்.
சோ அது கோ எக்ஸிஸ்ட் ஆனாதான் துவனி, ரெண்டுமே வியங்கியார்த்தத்துக்கு இருந்ததுன்னா
விவக்ஷா இருக்கணும். விவக்ஷா, see, whatever the poet is trying to convey is not the mere words. He has to, the tatparaveva shabdarthongiradhu adhudhane unakku. He has to put in an effort to highlight that dhvani. That is his goal here. So that is the kavi vivaksha. And tatraiva chamatkaritvam api bhavitavyam. That is an ideal situation that we are talking about. It is a utopian world if chamatkaratvam and vivaksha are there. Yeah, not always it happens. That is why this entire discussion happens. Puriya
illa illa, okay, adu puriyirudhu. But well, in the edathla vandu if I say pradhana vivaksha vandu anda yaar pesaraano avanukku vandu anda innor aalta sollano nee vandu evlo nandri kattavana iruka அப்படின்றத ஹைலைட் பண்ணணும்ன்றது தான் அவனோட இன்டென்ட்
இருக்கலாம். பட் தி இன்டென்சிட்டி ஆஃப் தட் இன்கிராட்டிட்யூட் தட் ஹி ஹஸ் ஷோட் இஸ் ப்ராபபிளி வாட் தி போயட் வாண்ட்ஸ் டு கன்வே த்ரூ தி ஸ்லோகம் மோர் தென் யூ ஹவ் நாட் பீன் கிரேட்ஃபுல் டு மீ அப்படிங்கறத விட ஹி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு கன்வே தி இன்டென்சிட்டி ஆஃப் தட் பிட்ரேயல். So that intensity is the vivaksha, and that is where the chamatkaritvam lies.
Ah, okay.
Adha sagradayatvam. If you can understand where the vivaksha is and where the chamatkaritvam is, then you will know whether the vachyartha is chamatkari or the vyangyartha is chamatkari.
Okay. The intensity in sonna puriyartha. Okay. Adnal da upaskar upaskaranam aidrathu, I guess.
உத்தம
காவியம் சொல்லிடலாமே அப்போ, வை இப்படி
வச்சுக்கணும். Half in the, 80% of the time, I think I appreciate Guni Bhuta Vyangya more. But yes, they are also, you should know, that's why you should know. Okay. Namaste.